Hi guys, I've got another topping tonight. Working my way through the set that I got a couple of months ago. Once I've worked my way through, I will show you the set in its entirety, but I'll do it one by one for now. So in the set, this is the first one of the 20th century. It's a 1907 Georgian Dragon Sovereign. Very attractive, this one. It's still got quite a lot of the luster left to it. It's graded as a good, very fine. There is a bit of wear here, especially in that area, but as a coin in hand, it's very attractive. It's also a what we would class as a short tail. If you see it there, let me zoom in a tad more if we can. We have got just two tiny wisps of hair there. So that is a short tail sovereign. Beautiful looking coin that. It has the upright diaxis, so the heads and tails are the same directions. And there we have Edward the VII. He came to the throne in 1901, but we only got coins with his portrait on from 1902 to 1910. It was a very short reign. When he comes to the throne, he was 59. He was the oldest son of Queen Victoria. And apparently he smoked a lot, and that brought to an end to his early demise. His portrait on the sovereigns is the first one that you could actually get with the Canadian Mint. The Victorias were on the Australian Mints, the Melbourne, Perth and Sydney, I think I'm talking about around about 1870, 1871, 1872. And in his reign, they opened up the Canadian Mint. Gold was discovered in the Yukon early 1900s. The UK government gave the Canadian government the go-ahead to produce a mint and start making sovereigns over there. But that wasn't up and running until 1908. So there's only two short years where you can actually get sovereigns with Edward the VII with a Canadian mint mark in the exergue here. So this one's a London, so there's no mint mark there. But if you get one with the C there and it's Edward the VII, you're incredibly lucky because there's not many of them around at all. So a bit of a fact for the evening. But as you look at it there, it is lovely. I've also got a couple of coins back from an auction just recently. I'll briefly let you look at this one. It is absolutely mega. This is an 1876, and it's almost proof-like. Got a few little rim nicks on it, but I don't care. I've not paid tons of money for this, and I'm well happy with it. Just let me. Victoria Younghead. Absolutely stunning that. The fields on this coin are absolutely amazing. I will show that in another video when I get a little bit more time. But well happy to get that, and I didn't pay a lot of money at all. So if you shop smart, you don't have to pay bags of money out. So I'll end this evening on that. Good looking coin. Got quite a few more to come with the original set. And like I say, you can see it all in one go. There are some lovely coins to come. There's one in particular, a few coins from now. And in terms of eye appeal, it's not an expensive sovereign, but in terms of eye appeal, there's one in there which is absolutely stunning. So one last look. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon with more gold sovereigns. See you later. Ta-da.